done. It's done. Curses, what do I do now? How do I go on living?
Is something wrong, Zelkov? I can lend an ear if you wish to discuss whatever it is.
That is very kind of you, but I doubt you would truly understand.
Try me.
One of my pursuits has come to an end.
Oh, you're broken up over a hobby? I assumed it was something more serious.
The word hobby is insufficient to describe what is absolutely paramount to me.
I see. Apologies. Please, go on.
I had been nurturing a young bird. Her parents had abandoned her. She had not yet learned to fly. I took it upon myself to care for her. In doing so, I became something of a foster parent.
Aw, how adorable.
It is done now. She has gone.
She escaped?
She has left the nest, taken her rightful place among the clouds.
Pardon me, but isn't that a good thing?
Yes, it was my intention from the start. Indeed, as an instructor, I am proud to see her fly away all on her own. But as a father, I am consumed by loss. Do you understand my problem now, Citrine? Do you have a solution for me?
I could purchase a similar-looking bird for you to care for, or hire a search party.
No, that won't do.
In that case, there likely isn't much I can do.
I understand. In that case, I will take up no more of your time. This will be my burden to bear.
I'm sorry, Zelkov. I wish there was something I could do to help. Come on in. Okay, just leave it to me. These expensive ingredients make me so nervous. I didn't waste a single scrap of food on this one. Yummy!
A solid meal to build solid muscle.
Here, I made you a to-go meal. Hope you like it.
So, where are you from?
Ooh, look at you, shooting off questions like barbed arrows out of camouflage. Sit an ambush like that, and you're liable to drag a straight answer out of me.
Great, so let's have it.
Dang. Somewhere in, Brodia?
Oh, I see. Thanks for opening up.
Listen, could I ask you to keep a lid and, like, 8 padlocks on this particular jar? Things could get unpleasant for me if this gets out and folks start connecting dots.
Gotcha. My lips are sealed.
Thanks, Alfred. Look, I know you want us to talk more, but it's not quite that simple. It could get really bad for both of us if you ask me the wrong kinds of questions. I've got a lot to hide. And I don't want to lie to you, but if you put me in that position, then I absolutely will. Because it's far preferable to the trouble that could find you if you learn too much about me. I'm sorry, that's how it has to be, but...
No, I get it. I won't push you. I'm not out to make you uncomfortable.
I appreciate that, Alfred. Truly.
But I said last time I wanted to talk more with you, and that's what I'm gonna do. It doesn't have to be personal stuff. We can talk about anything. Like our favorite flowers.
Yes, love it! Henceforth, your brain's gonna be stuffed with obscure weapon factoids.
Thank you. I have been waiting for this.
I shall serve as your opponent today.
I must continue to improve. I am Vander, 32nd Steward of the Dragon.
I'm, Jean. Should I really be here?
No!
It's been an honor sparring with you.
Shall we say, with age comes wisdom. I have been waiting for this.
Let's try not to hurt each other, okay?
Why me?
It's been an honor sparring with you.
Shall we say, with age comes wisdom.
I don't see any Illusion soldiers yet.
They're likely headed for the castle. We better go to Flora Port. That's the port closest to Fearnay Castle. You might remember it from your first time here.
Right. My first time here. I was so taken in by those beautiful rolling hills. Oh no.
What's wrong?
Smoke. From the northeast.
That's the direction of Flora Port. Oh, they must have... No, no, no!
Let's go. Flora.
Why would they do this? These people aren't soldiers. Farmers live here. Families.
Don't give in to despair, Alfred. For your kingdom's sake, we have to be strong. There are more Illusion warships off the coast. If any more make land, Fearnay will crumble. We need to fend off the incoming vessels and then rescue as many villagers as we can.
Oh dear, what a mess. Ugh, the smell from that smoke, it's really quite horrid.
Zephia. And Vale, you two. I'm guessing this is your handiwork.
No, absolutely not. We only just got here. I heard you'd be coming to Fearnay and I wanted to talk.
Why do you think we're here? Because we saw Illugia's army coming. Your army. The one that's burning Flora to the ground. You're Sombron's daughter. How can you not know what his forces are doing?
I'm not sure. Gris, did you order this attack? Is that how you knew where to go? Gris, tell me!
Sure, I knew about the attack, but I'm not the one who gave the order.
Well then, who did? What monster told our forces to attack a town of innocent people?
Why, it was you.
What?
The homes up in smoke, the people burning to death, crying for help, any help at all. It was your design, your command.
Mine?
We finally made it. What did I miss?
Forgive our lateness. There was a complication.
Arnie? Mavir?
Hey, Lady Vale! Hope you've had some rest after that long trip. Guess I'm a little late. But I am ready and raring to kill everyone in town, like you said!
What? Why would you do such a horrible thing? Those are innocent people!
Innocent? It's not like you to care about that. Oh, I get it. You switched, huh? You're the boring one.
Switched? The boring... What do you mean? Someone explain this to me!
All right. It was a chore dealing with you anyway. I'll tell you the truth. You should hear this as well, Divine One.
The truth?
You want to know why you're clueless? Why you can't remember ordering the attack? Because it was the other Lady Vale's doing, along with every other move we've made.
The other Vale?
Lord Sombron desired a fell child suitable to carry on his legacy. You disobeyed him, failed to use your fell dragon powers, wished for peace. You were a defect, unworthy of your parentage. Thus, Lord Sombron gave me the power to make a few adjustments.
What adjustments?
What did you do to her?
It was simple, really. I strengthened your draconic impulses the teensiest bit. Then you thought nothing of killing humans. You embodied Lord Sombron's will. Killing Lumera, stealing the rings, unleashing the corrupted across Elios. All you're doing.
That's why I kept waking up in places I didn't recognize.
Yes. As your consciousness slept, the other was awake, carrying out her work. Think of it. You fighting the corrupted that you had created. But it gets better. The fell dragon's daughter and the divine dragon became friends. Hilarious, isn't it? And pathetic.
No. No! I'm sorry. You're right. I've done horrible things.
The person who killed my mother and stole our rings, it was Vale, but not...
There you have it, Lady Vale. I'd say the misunderstanding has been resolved.
Sepia, Gris, Marnie, Mavir, you weren't my friends. I'm alone. I've always been alone.
Vale, it's all right, please. Let me help you.
How about no?
From this point on, I no longer have any need of you. Sleep now. Go on. Drift off into a dream.
No!
Time to wake up, Lady Vale. We do need you. I know how disappointed you would be if you were to miss the bloodshed.
You're a liar! Nothing like that!
Thank you for waking me, Zephia. I've been so looking forward to having some fun. Fetch me the ring of the Hero King.
Yes, as you wish.
Marth!
And my hounds, prepare yourselves as well.
Whatever you desire, my lady.
How exciting this is. I hope they have the endurance to at least resist a little. It's no fun if they just die. Right? Don't you agree? You know, seeing as how I don't share memories with that pathetic little girl, I simply had no idea you and I were friends now. I hope that you can forgive my rudeness.
Your apology means nothing to me. You're not Vale. Give her back!
Rest assured that I am Vale. Yes. In fact, I am Vale in her truest form. Only one of us deserves the honor of calling the Great Bell Dragon her father. That honor belongs to me and me alone.
My friends, it's time to fight!
Oh, that's right. I have an exciting surprise for you.
Ivy, and you, Divine Dragon. It's been some time, has it not?
King Hyacinth! Father! You're alive?
He's not. This is corrupted Hyacinth.
You mean...
Looks good as new, Not like Father's King Morian. I can do much better than that. When I create the corrupted, they're just like themselves. But at times, that can be a hindrance. So I made some modifications.
This is unimaginable!
Princess Ivy earned this.
Why me?
For stealing the rings from Destinia Cathedral. Ever since then, I have longed for vengeance. Hyacinth. I intended to give you the ring of the Lady of the Plains, but your daughter stole it. Take this instead. The ring of the Sage Lord.
Yes, Lady Vale.
You would have me fight my own father? No. You can't treat people like this. Don't you understand how cruel this is?
Cruel? This is easily the most fun I've ever had. Speaking of fun, all of the emblem rings are here. Six on your side, six on mine. There's no telling who might win.
Vale.
Now then, let the killing begin.
Lady Tiki!
Erica! Whatever you need. Allow me. Was that too much? Of course. Thank you.
The stage is mine.
I am ready to serve. Thank you. Did you see that?
Here goes.
My will is firm.
As your steward.
Your steward's ready.
Allow me.
Tell me what to do.
All is set. You hit me, I hit you. Let's get this pain party started.
You're too kind. I will never fail. I claim this victory. I'll go first. Please die.
For the divine dragon.
Me strength and victory. If this is war, so be it.
Kill for me.
I'm okay. Thank you. as your steward. Emblem, engage!
Delicious pain. Let's do that again sometime.
With him at my side, I'm invincible! You're going down for sure! Sorry! Die!
I can still fight.
The time has come.
Here we go.
You're nothing.
How professional.